This is 25 kilograms of black soldier fly larvae that I've just harvested from my farm, and I'm so excited to teach you how to start the cheapest BSF farm ever.
Now, if you've not subscribed to our YouTube channel, you don't mean you're going to miss out on our next video when we talk about when we do an experiment feeding day old chicks from day 1 to day 30 using black soldier fly larvae and commercial feed. So we're feeding three day old chicks from the 1 to the 30 with black soldier fly larvae, and we're feeding the remaining three with commercial feed from day 1 to the 30. I want to see which one will perform better. If you've not subscribed, you are going to miss out on that video. So click on the subscribe button right now so that you don't miss out on that video when we post.
This video is broken into two parts. I'm going to talk about the love net. I'm also going to talk about the substrate and how you can start without breaking the bank. Now, it's important for you to know to start very small, because you want to test the waters to know if black soldier fly is the best fit for you. But rest assured that black soldier fly larvae will cut down the cost of feeding your livestock, whether you're feeding your fishes, you're feeding your pigs, you're feeding your chickens, by more than 50%. And with the rich protein available in these larvae, it is a win-win situation for every farmer. So let's get into the video. So now, this is the love net. Now, the love net is an incredible part of this entire journey. Unfortunately, I don't have any flies in here because I was away for a short while. I couldn't keep up with the production of my colony, okay? But then, this is what a love net looks like. I constructed this one. Now, the love net is where you keep your flies. Where your flies, they breed, they mate, and they lay eggs for you. And that egg is what you now harvest. You harvest the egg, you incubate the eggs, and the eggs turn into minuscule larvae that you intend grow to get these larvae. Okay, so what and what do you need to know about the love net? Now, the love net, one of the things you need to do about the love net, once you're able to get something small, maybe not like this, because as a new farmer, you want to test the waters to see if it's the best fit for you. You can get 1 meter by 1 meter by 1 meter. Get a square net. You can meet a tailor or anybody who knows how to sew and get a net-like material to sew 1 meter by 1 meter by 1 meter, which will give you a square. And you can tie rope on the four ends, and that can serve as your love net. Now, bear in mind that your love net needs something like a sunlight to come into the cage or the love net in order for them to be able to mate effectively. Now, if there are no adequate sunlight in your area, then you have to provide artificial lighting that will serve as the sunlight, because without the sunlight, the flies, the black soldier flies, they will not mate. Okay, which brings us to the next part. All right, now, for the substrate that you need to collect your eggs in your love net. So you need a bowl, and then you need to go to the slaughterhouse and get some liver, some kidneys, or some intestine, or even just some meat, and allow them to spoil. Okay? Now, you put your meat here. I have mine here. Then you get nets and put it over it. The reason why you are doing that is so that the flies cannot gain access to the meat itself. Now, for your eggies, we have two kinds of eggies. Now, the first type you could use is this type. What I did here is I got some cartons and I cut them into shape. I wrapped them like this around. Then I have rubber bands holding them together. Now, the reason for this carton is because you see that there are holes in here that the flies can easily lay their eggs, and it will hold the flies. It will hold their eggs, okay? Same with this one as well. You can leave them on top. But if you don't have access to cartons, which I think is the simplest part of it, you can also get slabs of wood like this and tie them together with rubber. But in my own case, I'm using these, okay? And you can use either this one or either this one and put.
Flies in, I have to do it very fast so that that the flies does not escape, because if they escape, there will be shortage for you as a farmer. So once we've done that, the next thing we should talk about is setting up your crate. To start up their crate, to do their crate. So you can get plastics from where they sell it, which can be a bit expensive for someone who wants to try or test the waters. So in my case, I decided to start with used tires. You can virtually get these used tires from anywhere in the world where people use cars. They are basically free. So I got some bags, used bags. Then I got staplers. So what I did is to staple this rand just like this. This is me forming my own crates. Very straightforward. This will serve as where my larvae are going to stay, feed, and grow. Okay. This automatically becomes my crate. Now here I'll put in my my substrate. Now when you are forming your substrate, there are two things you need. One, you need a drum or a bucket that you're going to store your waste. Now, what are you going to use as your waste? What are you going to use as your substrate in feeding your larvae into my substrate drum or my fermentation drum to get some substrate to put into this crate? Now, this is what my fermentation drum looks like. I can keep my feed here for a couple of months, even for 12 months, and they will still be very, very nutritious for my larva. Right now, I can even see some gigantic larvae in my substrate. Possibly, some black soldier fly made their way in here to lay some eggs, and that's why I'm seeing some gigantic larvae here. That's why it's important for you to keep your substrate in a fermentation drum. It will increase the nutritional value of your substrate. Here we go. Starting out, you need to get two of these tires. Two of these big. Get a mini drum that you use as your substrate. Now look at the size. Look at the size of this larva. Let's go and compare the one I have. Look at the size of this larva. One is humongous, the other ones are small. Because these ones have been in the fermentation drum feeding there, so they can grow very big. Now for those ones, I didn't have enough time to give them food. I just left them there to eat what they could get. That's why they are not that big. But I want to harvest them and use them for something. Now, your substrate should be about 1 inch deep. It should not be too much, so that they can get, even if they are burrowing deep down, they can get air. Okay, now once you have these two, you've gotten eggs from your love nets, then you need two of these. So at the starter, you're starting at, you need two of these, just two of these, and with just 4 or 5 grams of eggs, black soldier fly eggs, okay, you can start with these. Now, once you have this, you get your fermented feed. And I told you that the reason why we are fermenting our feed is so that we can increase the nutritional value of our substrate. Now, what substrate am I using? This is what I'm using. I'm using burial waste mixed with PKC. Some of you don't know what PKC is. PKC is actually palm kernel extract, okay, or palm kernel cake, the waste from palm kernel and the likes. So I'm using burial waste, PKC, fiber, water, and biscuit waste mixed together. That's why the larvae that I saw inside my substrate, they are so big. They are like three times bigger than the one I have in the basin. Okay, so that combination of substrate will give you the best result. Now, some of you may say, oh, I don't have fiber water. What is fiber water? Okay, even if you don't have fiber water, you can use that PKC. Okay, and some of you may not have access to PKC because of the country where you live. You may not have access to burial waste. If you don't have access to burial waste, what you can also use is you can use chicken waste. If you have access to pig waste as well, you can mix pig waste and chicken waste, mix them together, it will form a wonderful substrate. But take note, you need to allow it to ferment for a couple of days. You need to keep it in a drum. If you don't have this kind of fermentation drum, you need to keep it in a drum, a plastic drum or a plastic container that is big, the lid, and cover it for a couple of days. Now that may increase the nutritional value of what you want to feed your larvae. Okay, that's how you start the cheapest BSF farm. If you have watched to this time, I want you to comment the city or the country you're watching this video from. I want to choose two persons that I will send 40 grams of egg. Two persons I will send 40 grams of black soldier fly eggs, and also one lovelet in order for you to start your colony. And if you want to learn more from me, you can reach out to me on the WhatsApp number on the screen. And just for your information, we have more videos coming up on black soldier fly lava that you don't want to miss out on. You have to process black soldier fly lava without an open and without any special equipment. Okay, so there are not a lot of videos on YouTube showing you how to actually process this lava. And please, if you're not subscribed, subscribe, because there's a video I want to make. I'm going to show you how to package it and sell it online or sell it offline. So, but then today I'm going to show you how to process your maggots. So this 25 kilograms of black soldier fly larvae, I'm going to process it. It's pretty simple. Well, I know some person may feel that it's a bit gruesome, but then it is what it is. So the steps are simple. First, you get hot boiling water. This is my hot boiling water. I'm not at home, so I had to use firewood. That's how we do it in Africa. Okay? So this is my hot boiling water. So I'm going to turn it in here. They're actually going to die. I'm sorry. But then that's how we're going to do it. So once I pour in the hot water, I'm going to allow it to sit. Then I'm going to scoop the lava out of the hot water. Then I'm going to spread it somewhere else. So let's go. I don't know if this water is hot enough, but we are still swimming. We are still swimming in it. So I'm going to allow it to sit for a little while.
You are sure that they all actually go down. Now that I've done this, this is not anything gruesome. It's just the procedure. Because even if you're using an oven, you're still going to heat them up and kill them. Then, this is the best way to go about it.
larvae here, okay, and allow the water to drain. Now, my greenhouse I'll construct it later tomorrow. That's why I'm going to now keep these larvae for them to dry. We're not using oven, we're using sunlight, and we're also using the greenhouse to dry these larvae. So, so like I rightly said, I said these larvae is what I'm going to use to feed the day old chicks from day 1 to day 30, and then I'm going to get commercial chicken feed that I'll use in feeding the other set of the day old chicks. By the end of the day, we're going to see which of them performs better. But I think I already know the answer. So there, if you've not subscribed, you need to subscribe so you don't miss out on that video. So as you can see, all of them are ready. Okay? They're ready.
Me spreading the 25 kilograms of processed, or should I say processing, larvae into where I'm going to dry them.
It doesn't look like it right now, but I know we're getting there.
Me drying out our black soldier fly larvae that we're trying to process, and it's important to do it like this, and I think this is the best way to dry them instead of using an oven, because when you use oven to dry this, we're going to end up burning away most of the protein, most of the most parts of the larvae that will make the larvae to be less nutritious.